there's something else happening in classrooms that's even more revolutionary. Something that teachers and students recognize wherever project-based learning is practiced.
The most transformative thing that I've seen with the technology, with project-based learning, all of it, is just simply the way that it empowers the students, the responsibility that they take for learning.
No longer is the student just this recipient of information, and the teacher just the dispenser of information. But now the student is someone who has the ability to construct and create information.
It's making the students strive for more and more excellence.
You want to do projects and you get more active in your projects and you want to make it the best it can be.
It makes you want to work harder because you know that you have the opportunity to make something great.
In the future, the possibilities for engagement through technology will expand exponentially. Irving ISD gives us a glimpse of that future. Here, forward-thinking educators have broadened the concept of technology integration into the design of the school itself. The first school in the country to produce more power than it consumes.
The building is built with geothermal wells, solar panels, wind turbines, and like rainwater harvesting devices so that it can maintain and create enough energy on that property to be able to sustain the energy that it's used through a school year. They'll do modules there. They might build their own wind turbine. They might go outside on the deck and see the solar panels that are on the roof. It's going to have an environment to create a constant push for creative thinking and problem solving and in innovative ways of doing curriculum. It's very powerful to know that on the first day this campus opens, I might have 750 kids that 10 years from now might be global leaders in green technologies because of the experience that they got to have in this building.
All of this sounds exciting and inspiring, but what have we gained from technology integration to date? Has it produced measurable results?
The first year of implementation, we immediately saw great results.
In science, 80% passing rate, which is phenomenal. And all my math and science teachers had 0 years teaching. The following year, last year, we had a 73% passing rate in math and a 85% passing rate in science.
The attendance data for the first year at the Manhattan U Tech High School was a 97% attendance rate. And for a secondary or a high school to have that large percentage of 97 percentile attendance rate is phenomenal.
Students who have never passed the state assessment or were always, you might say, in the wrong place at the wrong time, ISS or suspended, they're coming to school. They're engaged. They're passing the state assessment. They're passing their classes.
My grades have greatly improved since I've come to New Tech.
And I think that having all of the technology right at our fingertips, right whenever we need it, allows us to learn in a way that's suitable for us as individuals.
They showed us that it's not that hard, that we can do it, that I'm actually smarter than I thought I was. And now I know that for a fact that I'm going to college.
We took students from here and got them to here.
In the TIP program, the way the outside evaluator measured success is she did focus groups with parents, with teachers, with principals, and with students. We looked at some student data on various benchmark scores, test scores, and that sort of thing. And the data came back really overwhelmingly showing that, number one, students were more engaged, they became more independent in their learning, and over time we saw increases in math scores and other areas along that line.
Some kids, technology, no technology, they're either not going to do the work. But for those kids who struggle, the kids who, you know, borderline, you know, is going to push one way or the other, it's pushed them up.
The joy of that comes back to learning is something that is just immeasurable, but you can see it in students' faces. We can see it when it's used effectively. There is a drop in discipline problems, attendance goes up, and that's true not just in Klein, that's in research that's done across the nation.
I think it's really paid off. We have some great stories of students getting into college or getting jobs based on the fact that they had all this great training using technology in our district. And I think it has given them an edge over others.
The biggest change for our district with integrating more technology into it, obviously the first thing you see is our TAC scores. You know, our kids are achieving. We began looking at our committed performance students, for example, about 4 years ago. And we had roughly about 20% of our students were committed performance. Now it's about 50%. I mean, it's just the kids are becoming more active. They like coming to school. We have a very high attendance rate because it's fun to come to school.
They spend more time. They want to be in there during lunch, during afternoons. They want to come in during other periods when they're not doing anything. When they're extending their own learning and expanding on their own learning, to me that's success. And you will reflect it in your TAC scores.
We've seen a big increase in our commendable performance on the TAC test as well.
From a teacher's perspective, the benefits are equally exciting and transformative.
It's almost like night and day, the difference between before the computers and after.
What I find in using a lot of the technology that we have used is that it becomes a lot less about the grade and more about the learning. And I think really and truly in education, that's where we need to go.
The interactive whiteboard, the assessment tool, the software and the laptop allowed me to do the things I had always envisioned as a teacher in my classroom. And when you had struggling and gifted learners in your room and every learner was running to get into the classroom every day, my attendance was up and my discipline was down. And what greater gift to have as a teacher than to have those two things come together?
The rewards are, I think, pretty simple and straightforward, that you get students, children who are motivated by what they're doing and who are excited about what they're doing. One student said to me during the break, he said, "This is so good what we're doing now."
A classroom teacher that's been teaching longer than I have stood up in front of the board members and said, "It's like starting all over. I'm excited to go to work. I love what I do, and the children are excited to come to my class." You can't ask for anything better than that.
Anytime you align people with their passions, they're going to be great, not good.
I'm overwhelmed and I am so pumped for what we can do in the months and years to come with our students, because it's just opened up a whole new world for us.
Quite honestly, I have to tell you, every day that I walk into a classroom and see the magic that teachers are creating with technology and see the power of the products that students are creating, you just know we're on the right path and we're going to continue to get there.
Rather than asking them to power down and to shut off, we're finally meeting students where they are.
If you got into the profession to truly reach students, to truly make a difference, to truly affect the future, then you need to start doing things in a way that reaches this generation of students, the way that will have an impact on the future. Give them skills that they're going to need to succeed in the world that's coming. You know, don't get them prepared for the 20th century. That's over and done with. Get them ready for tomorrow.
To learn even more about getting your students ready for tomorrow, go to powerontexas.com and join the digital learning revolution.